I'm Kirsty Keane, and this is Neo Makeup. So today we're going to do this look, which is inspired by anime and also my hair, because I'm now pink to lilac, so we thought we'd do a look that matches my hair. And it's also inspired by Marilyn Monroe's beauty spot, but we've done a heart instead. So let's get started. So I'm going to start this tutorial by doing my foundation first, because clearly I need foundation. My skin is so bad at the minute. I think it's because the weather. Should we blame it on the weather? Because I've got spots and all blemishes and red chin and red cheeks. I think it's to do with the fact that it's so cold outside and I do some sports outside, and also coming indoors where the heating's on all the time. You know, if you live in a hot country, you don't have this problem, but in England, it's really cold at the minute. So I'm gonna do my foundation and make my skin flawless. So I'm gonna put on a base of Skin Base from Illamasqua. So I'm gonna dot it around first. I need more than that. I find this foundation gives a really good coverage. I'm going to blend that in with my sponge, and then we'll do contouring after I've got this base on, and I can cover any blemishes if they need more coverage after that as well. So the main thing I'm focusing on at the minute is to get a even coverage with the foundation. Now to contour. So apparently it's called NYX, but in the UK everyone calls it NYX as far as I know. So we're gonna do this kind of like an, I think it looks like an angel wing under the eye.
You want to be an angel?
Yeah, I am. Do we want to be? Then we're gonna go down the center of my nose. A little bit here and here, on the top of my lip, in the center of my forehead, and then these lines here we're going to highlight so they don't look as deep. And then to contour, cheekbones, give me some cheekbones, side of the nose. Slim it down, make it have a slim jim. We're gonna go across with the highlight first and blend that. The softer the sponge, the more the sponge will make contact with your skin, and that's what blends it. The harder, it won't blend it as good. Little top tip there. My nose isn't straight anymore, you know.
What?
Do you know what happened?
Why is your nose not straight anymore?
This is
a joke.
It's not a joke. This is like the truth. This is the real truth.
Kirsty walked into a bar and now her nose isn't straight anymore.
Literally walked into the bar. No. You know, my beautiful children. I love my beautiful children. However, pushing my children on a swing. Pushing Alicia on a swing. Getting a bit excited. I'd say we both were getting a bit excited, pushing her on the swing, pushing her on the swing. And she swung her feet back and kicked me full ball in my nose. I saw stars, blacked out for a minute, come round, was all of a dither with a bloody nose, blood coming out my nose, and my nose was swollen. Rang me mum because I really didn't feel very safe. I was a bit mom. Like, whoa. I mean, mum only literally lived across the road, and she come across and she was like, yeah, I don't think you should drive because, you know, you don't look like you're safe too. I was a little bit like her. And I went, is my nose still straight? And she went, no. Because with the swelling as well, it was a bit on. So it's not perfectly straight anymore. So the contouring is amazing to straighten that nose out. So when I'm doing the large areas of contouring, I'm using this round side of the sponge, pointy side. I'm sort of doing all the other more intricate stuff like the highlighting. So I've just got my number 7 translucent powder all the way up.
So
surprise,
messy.
Surprise, I'm making a mess already. Got it there, ready. Yep, we're all ready. Now we're going to do one eye at a time. I'm going underneath the eye, across the top of my cheekbone, and then a little bit across the top of my eye. Just make sure it's nice and blended. We can set that with a little bit of powder. Dabba 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 doo dabba doo dabba doo dabba 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 doo. I am going to powder contour now. Knock it off. Powder, knock it off. Powder, knock it off. And then we're going to sweep that into the cheekbone. The cheekbone's connected to the face bone. And then I'm just going to blend the cheeks a little bit. It's all about the blending. I got some brushes the other day. They were only cheap. They weren't, you know, really expensive.
They look like toothbrushes.
I just thought I'd give it a go. They're not toothbrushes.
They look like toothbrushes.
So I've got like things like and all that business.
That's like horse toothbrushes. It's massive.
Yeah.
They've got big teeth.
But these two, I really like, and I use them a lot. As you can tell, because they still have makeup on. And what I use them for is my contouring. So this little fluffy dude here, I put a little bit on, knock it off, and then I use him down the side of my nose. Don't forget we're going to blend this as well. And then that little tiny brush, you can use this highlighter in here, but OMG is shimmery. Is that a word?
No.
Shimmery.
It shimmers more.
It shimmers more. Go from the tip straight up. So I'm going to use a bronzer now, which is my faithful H&M bronzer. This is going to help blend the contouring as well and add a little bit of colour to the cheeks. And I'm going to bring that down my neck. So I'm going to use Dulcet, which is a pale pink, and it's got a slight shimmer in it as well. And I'm just going to put that over the top of my cheeks, which will highlight it at the same time because it's a pale pink, which is just going to add a little bit of pink to my cheeks, because this makeup is going to be pink and lilac, just so it matches my new hair. Now it's time for brows. We're going to do some killer brows. So I've got the NYX, NYX, and this is the eyebrow pencil crayon. Doesn't have a fancy name. It's literally thinner one side and fatter the other side. So you can do a fat line this way and a thin line this way. So first of all, I'm going to edge my brows. You can do each stage at the same time, so you know you're doing it the same. So I've gone out to the farthest point, and then we're going to cross over 3/4 away along the top and then down to the lowest point, and then the top line is going to go across and then down so they all meet. I'm going to fill this in only to that point. Then I'm going to use the Kabrow. So I'm wiping it on my hands so I get the brush really thin, and we're going to do some fake hairs. Now we need to seal this. We're gonna use the beautiful Jeffree Star palette. It's called, this palette is called Beauty Killers, because we are beauty killers. I'm going to use Vanity, and that will be used at the very end of this brow. Just on that section there. Then I've got my Grimace palette, and this colour is 565 that I'm going to use. So it's a lighter brown. And I'm just going to sweep that across the middle section. These powders slightly overlap each other. And then I'm going to use 564, which is even lighter. And we're going to sweep that across. So this paler brown is going towards the centre. So it's still a defined brow. It's not a full graduated brow, but it is slightly. I don't want it really dark in the middle because it'll make everything look really angry and really drawn in. And I can't do that facial expression because I've had Botox. I'm not afraid to tell you. I have this little brush, which is my cleanup brush. And it is even broken. That's how long I've had this for. And it's from Supercover, but it's a really cool brush for cleaning up. So I like to put on the back of my hand, because it's getting very messy at the moment, a little bit of the contour, put a little bit on, and I don't put loads, you see, I was just a little bit, and you can go in and really sharpen up the brows with that. You don't want a lot of the highlighter on the brush, or you just have one big highlighted clump of liquid, and you don't want that. You want it to blend nicely. And then we're going to use China White from the awesome Jeffree Star palette. Using a sponge, just highlighting under that brow. So we're going to use the Dulcet Illamasqua pink on our eyes now. So this is going to go all over this lid. We're going to use lilac around here. I am going to use, this is a little palette that I picked up, which is called Candy Girl. Picked it up just from a little shop that purely sells makeup. It's obviously a very good shop. And it's got lots of different colours in. So I thought we can use that. I'm going to use the pointy applicator. It's a bit easier to go under my eye. You're going to go right out. Bring that round. And then this is going to come up and over. And then we're going to overlap the pink onto that purple lilac to lighten it, and it'll just blend it as well. So overlapping the colours will blend any colour. Now I want to make this more magical. So we're going to have a little sparkle. So I'm going to use the Pure Pigment. Oh, this is that stupid name that I can't pronounce. It's B-E-G-U-I-L-E. Tell me what it says.
Beguile.
Beguile.
Not Beguile.
Not Beguile or Beguile.
You said Beguile. Beguile.
Beguile. Right, you get this stuff to really stick to your face. There's a little trick you can do. You can use eyelash glue and use the end of the brush. Pop a little bit in. And we're going to put it here. And I'm just going to dot it. Not a lot, you only need a little bit. And that's just going to make it really sticky. It's going to make, well, I mean, not like mega sticky. You're not going to like have things sticking to your face as you walk down the street. You're not going to have leaves sticking to your face or your hair sticking to your face. You know, it's just to stick the glitter. So this Pure Pigment, we're going to pick it up. Oh, just look. Magic fairy dust. Now this look is, yes, it's inspired by my hair, but it's also inspired by a little bit of anime. If you don't know what anime is, you must be over 25, maybe.
Hey, I used to watch anime when I was young.
Well, when you were young, exactly.
Manga.
Manga was brilliant. Yeah, I did watch manga.
I still watch manga stuff and okay. Anime stuff.
We're going to do some flicks now. The Illamasqua gel liner. Comes in a little pot like this. So I've got a slanted brush. And that's going to give you a nice thick, even line. And then we've also got a thinner brush. Use that to do super fine lines. I'll start in the corner. Then you can always use your other brush to do anything that you want a little bit more precise. So that's the eyes done, apart from the mascara. I'm going to put mascara on one layer and then I'm going to put lashes on. So I'm going to use the MAC mascara. This is a waterproof mascara as well. It's got a great brush, it really combs through. And bottom lashes. I'm going to let that dry a little bit. While I'm doing that, I'm going to get some lashes. So I'm going to use the Luxe eyelashes from Eyelore. These are reusable. These are the Mink Effect lashes. They're quite extreme. They're not really long. They just give you that wing out at the end. If you want to know how to apply eyelashes, we have a whole video just dedicated to eyelashes. If you check out the link here, you can watch that. What you can do now is apply another coat of your mascara to join your lashes with the false lashes. Now, to make this a little bit more anime, we're going to put a little bit of a beauty spot on. Now, as you said, Marilyn Monroe has a beauty spot that's not flesh, that's flesh coloured, so it's just risen. See this here? Mm-hmm. That's my beauty spot.
Oh.
Look. And it is raised, it's just not a dark colour. So I'm going to put it over there. So I'm using MAC Retro Black Fluid Line Pen. And to do a heart, it's really easy to do a little teardrop one side. And a teardrop on the other side. Now for the lips, you could just put a pink lip on. That would look really nice, but I have something I want to try. We have a Jeffree Star. Ooh, it's called Blow Pony. And it's lilac! Oh my God! This stuff is my favorite. You don't even need a lip liner with this because it's just so good. I mean, check out that coverage. I'm gonna let that dry a little bit. And I'm gonna use that pure pigment again. Oh, just because I love it so much. Just gonna use it here in the center. And that is this matching Kirsty's hair to her face. Makeup / anime / Marilyn Monroe. Luke, that's it, completely finished. I hope you have enjoyed it just as much as I have. I absolutely love wearing crazy makeup like this. So I love producing these types of videos just for you to have fun with. I hope you've enjoyed it. Have you? Give us a thumbs up if you have. The products that we've used today, I know they flashed up on the screen as we've been doing this tutorial, but they are in the description box below. Don't forget to subscribe to this new channel, which is Nao Makeup, and check us out on Instagram and Facebook. And I'll see you all in the next video. Just making sure there's no loose powder on my face. With my nice fan brush. This is my biggest fan.
Oh, dum-dum.
Did that take you a while to click in then?
It did, because it was this so bad.
This is my biggest fan. Is that a really bad joke?
That was horrific. That was a dad joke. That was like a real dad joke.
Now, with the contouring highlight, I am going to cover up any imperfections. Oh, you might be here a while.
Some people have commented, Kirsty, about you using highlighter to conceal.
Yeah.
Why is that? Because they said, well, isn't that the sort of...
job of what?
Well, it they're saying highlight is to highlight.
Ah, let me tell you this, though. So, when you... because the highlighter is a lighter colour than your foundation. That's exactly the same as what concealer is. You should always put it on lighter. Else, why wouldn't you just pile on the foundation thicker and cover everything up? So, the reason that you put on something lighter is because the imperfection that is under your skin is darker and you've got to counteract the darkness with something lighter.
So is it the same as when you're painting on nails?
Ah.
So you cover something with, like sometimes you'll do, like if you're doing a face, you'll do it white sometimes.
Mm.
And then you'll do your flesh tone on top of that if you've done it on a dark colour.
Yeah, because you've got to cover that up.
Boom.
Boom. You know some serious stuff now, I tell you what.
Adam needs to man up. Because he's womaning up at the moment.
He definitely are.
Far too much about nails and makeup.